5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, ignition, liftoff.
To the Get Healthy Talladega County Show. I'm Nancy Dixon, your host, and we're glad that you're watching today. We have a great group of people that are going to be on today. We have Pastor Gary and his wife Letetia Boles from Pinehill Seventh-day Adventist Church, and they're going to be talking about what they have going on in the community. We'll also have several from our Safe family who will be talking about parents as teachers, pre-K, and the HIPPY program. We invite you to come back and watch us in just a few moments.
Shawnee McNeil at South First Bank. This is a great time for you to buy or build a new home, or maybe refinance your present mortgage. Our rates are the lowest they've been in years, and that means saving you money. We've been helping our customers become homeowners in this area for nearly 70 years, and we can make our approvals right here in the office, and that means saving you time. We're located here in downtown Sylacauga. Come in and find South First, a better way to bank.
Member FDIC, an equal housing lender.
At Marble City Pharmacy, we're more than just a drugstore. Our gift shop boasts some of the most unique treasures you'll find anywhere. Come in and browse the vast selection of jewelry, purses, clothing accessories, and crafts. Let our friendly staff help you find that special card or gift for any occasion. Our dollar wall features selected sale items, and we stock a wide variety of specialty items. And if it is a drugstore you need, Marble City Pharmacy was named the 2015 McKesson National Pharmacy of the Year. Visit us today at Marble City Pharmacy.
Connect to nature. Connect to family. Camping World is here to help you make lasting memories. With thousands of parts and accessories available, service nationwide, and RVs as low as $109 a month, Camping World has it all. Now is your time to connect to excitement with savings on thousands of RVs. Plus, enjoy Good Sam Elite membership with every RV purchase. Visit your local Camping World Supercenter or shop campingworld.com today.
The Allen Companies of Sylacauga, with three locations to serve you: Highway 511, Highway 280, and Main Avenue. For all your convenience store needs, ice, drinks, snacks, and of course, some of the lowest price gasoline at the pumps. It's the Allen Companies of Sylacauga. Highway 511, Highway 280, and Main Avenue. It's the Allen Company convenience stores.
Welcome back to the Get Healthy Talladega County Show. And as I mentioned, we have Gary and Letetia Boles with us. This is Pastor Gary and Letetia Boles from Pinehill Seventh-day Adventist Church right here in Sylacauga. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
We have had the opportunity to meet you both several months ago, and it has just been a joy and a pleasure to get to know both of you as we have started working together on a project project.
Amen.
But before we talk about that, I wanted to hear, let the audience know, because you're new, you're relatively new to Talladega County. And I wanted the audience to get to know a little bit about you and how you came to Sylacauga and just to know more about you personally.
Okay.
Well,
you go ahead.
We came from Mississippi. We were in Mississippi about 12 years, and we moved to Sylacauga. He got a call to come to the church here in Sylacauga, the Pinehill Seventh-day Adventist Church. They moved pastors around and moved their families around. So as we came here, we've been here about 4 years, 4.5 years. I have four children, but three moved with me. And one was Gary. He likes to rap and sing. And then I have two other girls who moved with me and another daughter. And so we've been here 4 years. And I have found the community to be just very loving and very spiritual. They like to have church around here and to sing. And I've met a lot of beautiful people here in Sylacauga. And that's how we got moved here. My church members, they're all really beautiful people. And I've just been enjoying Sylacauga. We were in Huntsville recently, taking the kids back for spring break. And we were ready to get back out of Huntsville and get back to Sylacauga, where there's peace.
Oh, that's great. We like to hear that. It is. We do love our community and our county. And one of the purposes, the purpose for this show is to bring together our county and talk about and let the let our residents and our viewers know about great things that are happening in Talladega County, because if you don't know, you don't know.
That's right.
and so we really like to use this show as a platform to really communicate the people that are making it happen to in our county and to make it a better place to live. And so we look at mind, body, and soul. So we have just a wide range of people that are on the show from North Talladega County to South Talladega County and everything in between. So we thank you for being with us today. Reverend Boles, tell us a little bit about you.
It's a long story, in about 3-4 hours. You know, it's something. I've been in full-time ministry about 17, 18 years. Uh-huh. And, like, say, the church, they switches around 2 to 10 years. Mm-hmm. But there's no place like home. And, but everywhere you go, that's home. And I've learned to appreciate, because I'm from San Diego, California, lived in L.A., hated it. Oakland, so I'm used to being, the big city, but it just got too hectic, and Lord knew that and just kind of released me. And as far as full-time minister, I've been in kind of small cities and got to know the people. I met some of the best people in the world in some of these, the small cities and the little towns. You establish relationships with people, I believe, that will last for a lifetime. And so it was just exciting for us, to come down here in Sylacauga and to meet a new group of people, to be able to find out what's going on, in the city, what's going on, that's noteworthy, because so much negative goes out there, right. And some people are attracted to that. I like the new thing, the good things, the good stories, amen, that just warms people's hearts and change lives. And that's what that we're about, changing people's lives, and taking the holistic approach and mind, spirit, and body. And I thank God that, I've been able to do that. Even before full-time ministry, I was doing that and making a difference in people's lives, taking each day at a time. This day is the first day of the beginning of the rest of your life, and being able to bring out the good things in people and showing them, and then working toward setting goals, and, overcoming, the hindrances and liabilities and things like that, so that a person can be the very best that they can be and live life abundantly. And I think that's what the Lord wants us all to do.
Absolutely.
So I'm jazzed.
That reminds me, I was reading some scripture this morning about from James, the book of James, and it was talking about, consider it joy when you go through trials.
Hallelujah.
And tribulations.
Yes.
Yes, because there's none of us that are going to go through life without without trials, and how we are to look at that. And because when we go through trials, it develops perseverance, perseverance must do, you know, we must be tested to develop that perseverance.
Exactly.
And of course, I'm not quoting that scripture exactly, but it helps us to be mature.
Amen.
And complete.
So,
you know, that gives me hope as I go through my experiences, and I just loved what you shared about, you know, just helping people
along.
That's
what it's all about.
Yeah.
I am a brother and sister's keeper.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Well, we're so glad that you are in our community. Mm-hmm. And how we got connected mm-hmm. was a couple of months ago. I was with Margaret Morton, and she had attended an event at Verley Collins. Mm-hmm. And can you tell us about this event? Because she came back, I was not able to go that day, mm-hmm. and she came back and just was talking about what a wonderful event this was. And we're gonna introduce the community to your son in just a minute.
Amen.
Ago with some of his skills. But mm-hmm. Can you tell us a little bit about that event and who put that on? And
okay. It's about our objective. It's really world changing, kingdom building, mm-hmm. and it's only, you know, you have to be a part of the kingdom, you know, to really to be able to make a difference wherever you are, and so we believe that where we're placed, amen, that then that community should be better, and so you go on. It's like the methods of Jesus. That you can't really, you know, improve upon. There's a book, you know, Minister of Healing, page 143, and it says that Jesus went around to men and women, boys and girls, and showed that he had an interest for their greater good, and then he exhibited sympathy, you know, for the people. He loved them. He listened to them, and then he ministered to their deepest needs. And then he would bid them to follow. I don't think you can improve mm-hmm. upon those methods. That's what we do. We go into an area. It's finding out it through assessment, you know, what are the real needs of the community, not the assumed needs, but real needs of the community. And then to go, you know, find those needs and then network with different agencies, find out what the needs and then the resources to fill those needs. And that's what we do. As far as this particular event you're talking about, it was community outreach. And we have, you know, Monique Smith, who is our AYS, that's Adventist Youth Society, leader, and the Lord just laid a burden in our heart to just reach out, mm-hmm. you know, to community. We're factionized at so many different people and organizations, you know, that exist, but yet, you know, there's probably times very little contact. And so what we want is reach out in partnership with people. We want to unite hands and hearts together with a common goal, and to improve the lives of people in the community. So this event at Verley Collins was just to reach out to the community and invite the social agencies and faith great base, you know, ministries out there to come together and let's deal with things. Let's showcase what we have, the good things that we're all about, and let's bring people together so they can see mm-hmm. there are options. You know, there's help out there. You know, whatever your problem is, there is a ministry, there is a need, there's an organization out there that can help, amen, to fill those needs, and then to minister to you holistically, and not only to you, but your family as well. Mm-hmm. There are people who really do care, you know, and it's not all about the money, something at the bottom line, but it's about people. There's nothing greater than people. Amen. And be able to minister to them, because we love to see people happy and put smiles on people's eyes and warm their hearts. And that's what it's all about. That's kingdom. That's a kingdom initiative.
Yes.
And as far as what we do is try to reach out in every community in order to do that, to make that community better than when we got there.
Well, when we are going to take a break right now, but when we come back, we had mentioned your son, Gary, who performed at that
yes.
event.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to have a little bit of footage of him introducing himself, I believe.
Cool.
And we'll show that when we come back from our break. We'll be right back.
Hi, it's Shawnee McNeil at South First Bank. This is a great time for you to buy or build a new home, or maybe refinance your present mortgage. Our rates are the lowest they've been in years, and that means saving you money. We've been helping our customers become homeowners in this area for nearly 70 years, and we can make our approvals right here in the office, and that means saving you time. We're located here in downtown Sylacauga. Come in and find South First, a better way to bank.
Member FDIC, an equal housing lender.
At Fort Williams Pharmacy, you won't find motor oil, garden hoses, or mountain climbing gear. No, they don't have that. What they do have is a professional, friendly staff that understands your needs. Filling prescriptions is their primary business, and they take it seriously. They also have a drive-through window for your convenience and free local delivery. Most of all, Fort Williams Pharmacy knows your time is valuable. So when it's time to fill your prescriptions, you need it done fast, friendly, and accurately. Fort Williams Pharmacy, our family, caring for your family.
Connect to nature. Connect to family. Camping World is here to help you make lasting memories. With thousands of parts and accessories available, service nationwide, and RVs as low as $109 a month, Camping World has it all. Now is your time to connect to excitement with savings on thousands of RVs. Plus, enjoy Good Sam Elite membership with every RV purchase. Visit your local Camping World Supercenter or shop campingworld.com today.
Coosa Valley Medical Center, one of the top 10 hospitals in Alabama, is also Sylacauga's largest employer. Services from the emergency room, to surgery, to cancer treatment, to post-stroke care. You won't believe what's right in your backyard. It's Coosa Valley Medical Center in Sylacauga. So, if you're sick, in Alabama, choose one of the top 10 hospitals in Alabama. That is Coosa Valley Medical Center.
And I go to Oakwood University, where I'm a junior, theology major. And I really started, well, I grew up a pastor's kid. And so I was always singing in the choir from a young age and just around, you know, different musicians. Like, my dad plays the bass. But I was never really interested in music per se until about a year ago, where I really wanted to start making it for myself. And so it started off just as something, you know, I did like as a hobby, where I would write different songs and things like that. And so I started with some friends, like, you know, just doing them at church, you know, at different youth events and things like that. And so this past summer is where we actually started having outdoor concerts at the baseball field. And so we were able to like rent a PA system every Saturday, and we just set up and started doing outdoor concerts. And a lot of people from the community, like kids and young people, they came out just to see, you know, what was going on. And so when they started hearing the music, they were like, okay, that sounds pretty cool. And so that was a way to kind of bring them out and also like relay good and positive messages to them through music and, you know, through speaking, different things like that. Like, we had food and snacks out there. Just a good, like, fun, you know, family-friendly environment. And also that summer, I started working at Subway, where I saved up like all my checks, and I went and got like a lot of different recording gear to record. And so once I did that, I went back to school in the fall, and I started messing around with it, learned how to just start making beats and start recording. And that's when I started just, you know, putting my music out there. I had a friend who, he recorded like videos, so we started working together, and we were able to put, you know, music videos together and start, you know, I started showing my friends around campus, and, you know, people were like, oh, that's really cool. But I would say the main reason why I really started making music, or one reason I see like the purpose for it now, is to really relay positive messages to especially young people. Being young myself, I'm 21. I knew I grew up like in rap music. You know, that's just the generation I was in. And so for a lot of these kids out here, they like the same thing, but a lot of the messages that come with rap music today are really negative, and just persuade people or you know, pressure them into doing negative things. And so by me doing music, I see it as a way to kind of give those young people an alternative, something that sounds good, it's appealing to their ears, but also they can tell it's a complete difference from like the message of, you know, this song and, you know, the music I do. And so I see that as a way I can really just help a lot of young people who in today really they don't have a lot of positive role models to look up to. You know, they come from broken homes where their dad may not be there, or, you know, he's there, but they don't really feel like they have anybody that's really listening to them and just showing them the ropes. So for me, I just see it as a way to heal. You know, music is powerful. I see it as a way to bring people together, to heal families, to heal people's emotions, and really just lead them on the right path. And, you know, me being just a Christian young man, I see how important it is to share, you know, the messages God has given me with my family and with my friends.
Wow, that was a great interview.
I'm impressed.
I know you all are just smiling and tearing up.
He's
from
done
ear
well.
To ear. And for those in our audience, that was Pastor and Mrs. Boles, their son, Gary Boles, who we were able to talk with when he came back from school last week. Mm-hmm. And so we wanted to, in just a few minutes, we're going to have some of his music that he's going to perform for us, but you all were not in the room when that interview took place, so that was the first time that you got to hear and just to hear his heart coming out in that interview. Something he said about, you know, the music that he performs and positive messages, and he talked about how music resonates in your soul.
Sure.
That is just that's something that my daughter's dance teachers, she takes dance, and she has taken dance for 13 years at the dance studio in Sylacauga. It's dance and performing arts, but her dance instructors, Heather Adair, Gina Sumners, Beth Steers, they have instilled that in her too, and that's a message that they have told her is music. You know, there is something about music that stirs your soul, and it can and really change your outlook, what you're thinking and your thoughts. And he spoke about that so eloquently.
He actually drew some of the children, young men, in from the community, and they recorded a little song that it was really cute. So they enjoyed making up their own words and even after he left, because I think he kind of inspired them to do that. He really can draw these young people in because he has a heart for God and a heart for young people. And we just let him do what he does. And those kids that he drew from the community this summer are still coming to church, and they're bringing their friends, and they're calling me up asking, are we having church tonight? And I'm like, not every night are we having church. But they're consistent children. I see their lives changing just as a result of, you know, the pastor just allowing them to be who they are. And he uses that music, and they are writing lyrics and reading them to me. And I don't understand. I told him, you have to enunciate so I can understand what you're saying. But I'm not supposed to understand. They're supposed to understand.
And
it's just a way for them to give them something positive to do.
Yeah. I think we have a footage of that. That will be brought up. It's ready to go. So we're going to watch that right now.
Amen.
With a lot of homies, I know that you gave my trouble at your mama's house. Daddy wasn't there for you. Just look up to the sky, man. You won't have to sky me. You know I'm always there for you. Lost within the crowd, though. I know you feel so alone. You know that I got love for you. Even though you better, homie, keep your head up. They can't touch the real you. Trouble at your mama's house. Daddy wasn't.
that was impressive. And he had said that he had just started doing this a couple of years ago. And that was just a lot of fun to be able to watch and to listen.
He's excited, passion. You know?
Yes, he does. Mm-hmm. He absolutely does. And you know, and that I just love the message of the positive music.
Yeah.
And that, and again, we wanted to highlight that today about, you know, positive messages. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you hear about rap music
and it's bad
message, and, you know, and there is good. There's and that was, I think we were all blessed by that.
Amen.
That got to watch that.
I think he wants to change the world, he says, through his music. And I think every musician and artist wants to change the world and just make it a better place.
Mm-hmm.
And using the lyrics and the music to help people feel, you know, better and not worse, and send a positive message. And I'm really impressed with him because he follows his dad. Mm-hmm. His dad has always prayed, and my son, he's only 21, but he's always praying. My husband always reads his Bible. My son is only 21, he always reads his Bible. And so it just, if they catch, the young people can catch that spirit.
Uh-huh.
That's a positive thing. If you can read your word every day, it'll help you to have a better day, not just today, but throughout your life.
Transformational.
That's what we're
talking about, transforming our hearts.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, only God can do that. Only God can do that. We can't do it ourselves.
True.
But you all are doing a lot of outreach into the community. One of the things I wanted, and we'll just have a couple of minutes to talk about it, but you all are going to be feeding children after school.
Yeah.
And that's another one of the outreach. You've talked about these community events and these park events that you've been doing, but also now we have a community, a county, our kids are hungry. Our kids are coming home from school and they're hungry. And some are not getting fed until they go back to school the next day. And and so our community, Talladega County, is coming together to make a difference.
Right.
And you all have taken that torch. And so tell us a little bit, when are you going to be feeding after school?
Mondays, Wednesdays, Fridays. We'll feed the children in the evenings because they come to the church different times. Anyway, sometimes we have, you know, 23 to 40 children there. And so, you know, we're doing chips and drink right now, but when we start the feeding program, they'll get actual meals. So they come hungry. They come hungry for the word, but they also come hungry for food and nutrition.
Right.
And we want to give them some healthy snacks, and we'll be feeding them on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. And that's just a program that, thanks to SAFE, that we'll be starting at our church.
Okay.
And we'll do that, I think, for a couple of months before the summer ends, before the summer begins.
And that's, it's a really, I've become very familiar with the after school feeding program. And one of the things is it's good food. the other day I was actually at one of the high schools, and it was beef burritos, and they were huge. And the kids were really excited to eat that. And so, yes, you'll be feeding them with the word, and also feeding them with after school, with a dinner.
Right.
So we look forward to hearing more about that as you move forward in that. I believe you were starting in April. And so we look forward to hearing more about that and success. Any other events or anything that you would like to share?
There's something I'm highlighting that we're really focusing on now, and that's bringing our young people together in what is called a Christian Boy Scout. We get Cub Scout, Girl Scouts. You know, what we do is get honors. We teach them about leadership and creating leaders, and going and giving back, you know, to the community. We have, you know, the drill team. You know, we're going to start a drum corps. They can win honors. You know, we take them out camping and those kind of things. We teach them, you know, about just giving back and helping them to be the very best that they can be. So we inculcate kingdom principles, you know, to them, so they can feel good, you know, and understand what holistic health, abundant living is really all about, so they don't carry any grudges. We teach them things like goal setting and problem solving, decision making, budgeting, time management, et cetera, you know, and to help them to develop, you know, normally and prepare for leadership and to be productive citizens, you know, to really realize that gift of God has put inculcated excellence within them, and that's what we try to push them. You know, we have high expectations, you know, and love is the greatest power in the universe. Yes. And love will find a way, you know, and we've just seen miracles take place. When you amen, when children know that you really care about them, you know, and they know that you can even practice tough love sometimes because you've established that relationship.
Oh,
so we're preparing for a youth congress, and it's like, you know, five different states and all of your young people that are coming in there. Everything is geared toward young people, and all the music, seminars, worship, plenaries, and all of that. I mean, the best of food and coming together and training young people, but yet letting them hang out, you know, and bowling and skating and all those kind of things that that we get them involved in. It's just stuff, you know, may not all the time, you know, get on the news or whatever, but it's just good stuff that is taking place, and people's lives are changing. People are being delivered. People, I mean, are setting goals and are overcoming things. And just to be a part of that, investing, what greater investment than to invest in the lives of our young people. So we're preparing for that. You know, we've got to get vans and everything. We suiting them up and getting them dressed, and we're going to be ready to go in a short period of time. And that happens in April 27th
through 29th. 27th through 29th. Mm-hmm. Give us your phone number for anybody interested in knowing more about any of the feeding, the programs, the...
Amen. Amen. The phone number is area code 205-478-7784. 205-478-7784. Please, if you have any questions about anything, I mean, just give me a call. Amen. I promise I'll get back with you.
Wonderful. Thank you all for being with us
Thank
today.
You
Thank
us.
You for sharing just about you, about the church, and we look forward to speaking with you a lot more.
Let's get it on.
We'll be back in just a minute with Patsy Jones and Katina Harris from Safe Family Services Center as we talk about the pre-K program as well as HIPPY.
Shawnee McNeil at South First Bank. This is a great time for you to buy or build a new home, or maybe refinance your present mortgage. Our rates are the lowest they've been in years, and that means saving you money. We've been helping our customers become homeowners in this area for nearly 70 years, and we can make our approvals right here in the office, and that means saving you time. We're located here in downtown Sylacauga. Come in and find South First, a better way to bank.
Member FDIC, an equal housing lender.
At Marble City Pharmacy, we're more than just a drugstore. Our gift shop boasts some of the most unique treasures you'll find anywhere. Come in and browse the vast selection of jewelry, purses, clothing accessories, and crafts. Let our friendly staff help you find that special card or gift for any occasion. Our dollar wall features selected sale items, and we stock a wide variety of specialty items. And if it is a drugstore you need, Marble City Pharmacy was named the 2015 McKesson National Pharmacy of the Year. Visit us today at Marble City Pharmacy.
Connect to nature. Connect to family. Camping World is here to help you make lasting memories. With thousands of parts and accessories available, service nationwide, and RVs as low as $109 a month, Camping World has it all. Now is your time to connect to excitement with savings on thousands of RVs. Plus, enjoy Good Sam Elite membership with every RV purchase. Visit your local Camping World Supercenter or shop campingworld.com today.
The Allen Companies of Sylacauga, with three locations to serve you: Highway 511, Highway 280, and Main Avenue. For all your convenience store needs, ice, drinks, snacks, and of course, some of the lowest priced gasoline at the pumps. It's the Allen Companies of Sylacauga. Highway 511, Highway 280, and Main Avenue. It's the Allen Company convenience stores.
Welcome back to the Get Healthy Talladega County show. And today, for the second part of this show, we have Patsy Jones, welcome, and Katina Harris, both from Safe Family Services Center, one of our primary partners. We are so glad to have you both in the seated to talk about some of the great things that you have been involved with for a while at SAFE, and we look forward to hearing about that. Before we begin, I want to hear let the audience know a little bit about both of you personally. I know some of you may be familiar with Patsy and Katina, but if you could share with us a little bit about you personally.
Okay, I'm Patsy Jones and a retired teacher. I taught special ed at Sylacauga City Schools for 28 years. Came to SAFE to do a 3-year grant, and this is year 13, and thoroughly enjoying helping others in the community. So it's wonderful, enjoying my job.
What about you, Katina?
Well, of course, I started off with HIPPY, by mistake, actually.
Oh, tell
so
us
this
that.
Is my
tell
story. Okay. Actually, you know, of course, I was going to get my GED because they had a GED class at SAFE, and Miss Linda Burton had asked me about HIPPY, and that's how I heard about HIPPY. And I was thinking of filling the application to sign my child up for HIPPY, and ended up filling out a job application. So that's my story. I married, my two kids both did HIPPY, Justice and Derek Harris. And I've been there for almost 19 years, 18 years and counting.
So. That is hard to believe.
Yes, yes.
Time flies.
It does. It really does.
Well, we have said HIPPY several times.
Yes.
I know what HIPPY means, but let's go ahead and let everybody know, what does HIPPY mean? Because we have a lot of laughs about when we talk about HIPPY.
Yes.
We're not talking about the 70s.
Yes,
we're not talking about
peace
signs. Tell us what HIPPY is.
HIPPY is home instruction for parents with preschool youngsters. It's an early learning program for kids that's 3, 4, and 5 years old. As a parent educator, we go out to the home and we promote that the parent is the child's first teacher. The parent actually does the work with the child. Mm-hmm. We just take out a curriculum, give them the tools they need to teach their child. And I really loved it because when I had my own and they was doing HIPPY, I had to search, actually write stuff out for my kids. But when I had that curriculum right there, I didn't have to do any searching anymore. And that's what HIPPY does. They give you everything you need, the tools you need, the for learning the alphabets, their numbers, their shapes, their colors, comprehension skills. They get free books, they get the free material. Everything is free. It's no charge for any of it. Mm-hmm. And it's a great, great program to have. And my kids did a wonderful job. They loved it. And, you know, that was their homework. And, you know, now, you know, kids, you know, we know that school is more advanced. So getting kids to learn at an early age is very, you know, important. It's very important to start at 3, to start right now, because this program really gets you to the level that their child needs to be when they get in kindergarten.
And so how old are your kids now? Because they started off.
They did. Actually, HIPPY. My daughter started off a little early. You know, uh-huh. Back then it wasn't gear on the school system, so we could start them whenever. So my daughter started when I started, because I had to have a practice child. But she's 21 now, and my son is 20, and both of them are doing a great job. They did, you know, good in school. My daughter's in college, and she's doing well and working, and, you know, it's just a blessing. And that, the program really works, really works.
That, and you've been a parent educator for 18 years?
For 18 years, okay. And counting.
Wow.
What about the pre-K program? She has an interesting part to carry.
Okay, yes. Well, let's talk about pre-K. Yeah,
yes.
Let's hear about it.
Justice, she was actually one of the first class, to go to the first class of pre-K with Ms. Kay Jennings, who was the teacher then. She did pre-K for that first year, and then of course, about 2 years ago, mm-hmm. I got a letter from Ms. Kay talking about that they wanted to honor the first pre-K class. They got to meet Governor Bentley. He did a dinner and honoring them for being the first pre-K class. And also, when they went to the State House, they acknowledged them as being the first pre-K graduates. So it was a blessing that, you know, she was able to experience that.
Absolutely. Yeah. Now, when did that take place?
It was about two years ago. She was 12th grade. Yeah. She was 12th grade. So it's been about two years ago, yeah. So, yeah. And that was awesome. It was awesome because I was able to go and experience that with her. So, yeah.
It's fun to hear about, you know, all these different experiences.
Yes.
And because of a decision you made back that
from
many
the
years
beginning.
Ago.
From the beginning, yes, yes, yes. From the beginning, starting from, you know, not knowing, you know, how to get the materials I needed for my child, you know, until there was that resource there. Mm-hmm. And from that resource has led to another program, which, you know, the pre-K. And then from that pre-K, she also went into doing AmeriCorps. Mm-hmm. So she became AmeriCorps. So she, you know, with volunteering, but she, you know, did it through HIPPY. Mm-hmm. You know, she volunteered for HIPPY, you know, once she got old enough when she wasn't in it, and all the way until she did AmeriCorps, and she still volunteered. Volunteers till this day. So
volunteering is so important.
It really is.
It's so important to volunteer and be a part of the community. There's so many. One of the things with this show, with Get Healthy Talladega County, is we're bringing all these people together.
Yes.
I mentioned this in the last segment.
Mm-hmm.
Bringing all of these people, these agencies, mm-hmm. and all this great work that is being done all across Talladega County to make it a better place.
Yes.
And we are trying to enrich with mind, body, spirit, you know, a holistic approach, because we're not just bodies. All these things make us to be. So it's been so exciting to hear about, you know, just everything and how it's working together for Talladega County, because we have solutions, don't
we?
There's all these things that are going on.
Yes.
That just, you know, press us to, you know, make you just want to give up sometimes, and we don't have the answers, but we're all working together.
Yes.
To help. Yes. The next generation, as you've been talking about.
Yes.
and each other.
Yes.
So how many parents, how many families are involved? We'll talk about HIPPY, I guess, right now. How many families are involved with HIPPY?
135.
135 families.
Are how many we've served this year.
Okay, and what does that, is that Talladega County?
That's
just
in Talladega County.
Wow, and is this North County, North Talladega County?
This is all
Talladega County. Okay.
We have different parent educators. We have seven that go out into North and South.
Mm-hmm.
And we have two different group meetings a month. We have one for the North Camp part of the county and one for the Southern part. So as transportation's not a big issue for them to be able to come out. And the group meetings where the parent and child comes together, and then we use topics that the parents might be interested in, as car seat safety, gardening, all kind of different things that they might be interested in. And we take the children aside and do an activity, story time, and craft activity with them. And then we get them back together to go through some interaction that way. So it's really a wonderful, as Tina said, that HIPPY is the parent, we want the parent to become the child's first teacher, and to instill in them the love of education also, and see their child grow, so that that will continue to grow through the school years with the child. And research has shown that that's true, that the more they're involved in the early stage, the more the active they are later on.
Wow.
So it's I'll tell a little bit about the funding, that we're funded through the Department of Early Childhood Education. And it's a state-funded program. And we're real excited that we've been funded all these years since 1998 that we began.
Yes.
And it's a wonderful program that the children and families benefit from. And we are in partnership with Sylacauga City Schools, Talladega City Schools, and Talladega County. So we've got a great partnership with them.
Well, that's so comprehensive. I love hearing when we're doing things across all the school districts in the county. And so you have how many parent educators work on the north end of the county?
Well, we have three.
Mm-hmm. Two and a half.
We have
two and a half.
Yes. So, and then we have the others on this end of the county. It's wherever we need them.
Okay.
Is that we try to arrange it so because mileage, they have to get out, and we try to use our funds very careful with how we use our funding. And
we've got to go to a break. Okay. But if you want to know more about HIPPY, what is the number to call?
256-245-4343.
Okay, that is safe at 256-245-4343. We're going to go to break, and we come back, we will bring in Leigh Hall, who is the program director for Parents as Teachers.
Hi, it's Shawnee McNeil at South First Bank. This is a great time for you to buy or build a new home, or maybe refinance your present mortgage. Our rates are the lowest they've been in years, and that means saving you money. We've been helping our customers become homeowners in this area for nearly 70 years, and we can make our approvals right here in the office, and that means saving you time. We're located here in downtown Sylacauga. Come in and find South First, a better way to bank.
Member FDIC, an equal housing lender.
At Fort Williams Pharmacy, you won't find motor oil, garden hoses, or mountain climbing gear. Nope, they don't have that. What they do have is a professional, friendly staff that understands your needs. Filling prescriptions is their primary business, and they take it seriously. They also have a drive-through window for your convenience and free local delivery. Most of all, Fort Williams Pharmacy knows your time is valuable, so when it's time to fill your prescriptions, you need it done fast, friendly, and accurately. Fort Williams Pharmacy, our family, caring for your family.
Connect to nature. Connect to family. Camping World is here to help you make lasting memories. With thousands of parts and accessories available, service nationwide, and RVs as low as $109 a month, Camping World has it all. Now is your time to connect to excitement with savings on thousands of RVs. Plus, enjoy Good Sam Elite membership with every RV purchase. Visit your local Camping World Supercenter or shop campingworld.com today.
Coosa Valley Medical Center, one of the top 10 hospitals in Alabama, is also Sylacauga's largest employer. Services from the emergency room, to surgery, to cancer treatment, to post-stroke care. You won't believe what's right in your backyard. It's Coosa Valley Medical Center in Sylacauga. So, if you're sick, in Alabama, choose one of the top 10 hospitals in Alabama. That is Coosa Valley Medical Center.
Welcome back for our last segment of the Get Healthy Talladega County Show, and we have a new face. We have Leigh Hall that has joined Patsy on set to, Leigh's the program director for Parents as Teachers. Welcome, Leigh. We're glad to have you.
Glad to be here.
Well, can you tell our audience a little bit about yourself as well?
Well, I'm a retired educator. I taught Family and Consumer Sciences for 25 and a half years. And shortly after retirement, this opportunity came open at SAFE, and I've been there almost 3 years and really enjoy it.
It seems hard to believe it's been 3 years since you retired as well. Everything is just speeding up, yeah. It seems. But tell us a little bit about Parents as Teachers, and I want to see how we can talk about how parents and teachers work together along with HIPPY to work in our communities and families.
As coordinator of the home visitation programs, that includes HIPPY, and that includes Parents as Teachers, which we call PAT. And with that, the difference between the two is there's more interaction with the child from the parent educator or parent facilitator part than with the HIPPY program. The HIPPY program is working mainly with the parent to become the child's first teacher. PAT does the same thing, but they model the interaction between the child and the parent between the child and the parent facilitator, so the parent can model that with the child later and do that. So they kind of are, that's the difference that I see
in that. Is there anything else, Leigh, that you want to bring out with that?
Well, I know one major difference with HIPPY is, again, working more directly with the parent. With parents as teachers, the child must be present for the visit so that the interaction can be between the parent and the child, primarily with the parent facilitator facilitating that.
Mm-hmm. Now, what counties is parents and teachers? What are you all in, just Talladega County? Does it expand past mm-hmm. Talladega County for either of these programs?
We serve three counties.
Three counties,
okay. Coosa, Clay, and Talladega. Okay. And we serve 63 families is our capacity for that.
Parents as teachers. Parents.
And it's a federally funded program with MCCHPY mm-hmm. and through the Department of Early Childhood Education.
How, and you said 63 families mm-hmm. with parents mm-hmm. as teachers, okay. And then how often are you going into the home with each of these programs?
Okay. We mm-hmm. go into the homes twice a month mm-hmm. for an hour visit, give or take a few minutes, you know, depending on the what all they're doing. And again, work with the parent and the child there. In some cases, we have twins, and so they work with both of them then. And they put together lessons for each family on an individual basis based on what the parent facilitator is able to observe on every visit, and then also in talking with the parent on what their concerns may be for the child. So putting things together to help with that. We also do developmental screenings at least once a year to help the parent facilitator as well as the parent to see if there are any issues that might need to be addressed in other areas, like going to the doctor or something like that. We only do the screenings, we do not diagnose though.
Right, okay, yes, there's a difference in that, isn't there?
Yes.
Okay. Well, in Parents as Teachers has been here in Talladega County for how long?
We started our first visits in April of 14.
Okay, of 2014, mm-hmm. so right at three years. Okay. Mm-hmm. This is just, you know, we all need a hand, don't we? Mm-hmm. We all need a hand from time to time, and this just seems like, you know, just some assistance when you don't know who to talk right. to, who to go to. Right. You all just are partners in the relationship and helping your kids to develop those skills right. to prepare them for the future. Mm-hmm. Yeah, kindergarten is not like it used to be when we were growing up, is
and,
it?
And that we actually serve pregnant women. We can start serving them once they find out they're pregnant and they are referred to us, and if we have openings at that time. Right now we do have, I think, about four pregnant moms that we're working with, and just take to them information about, you know, what happens during that time period and things to expect when they do deliver the child and all. So we can start with them there, and we work with children up until the time that they enter kindergarten, you know, okay. as long as the parent wants to remain in Parents as Teachers with us. We can work with them over that time period, so it's just a constant progressing through the child's, you know, learning and everything through.
So prenatally mm-hmm. to kindergarten, and then HIPPY is from
three, four, and five year olds.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right, so would someone transition, could they be involved in both mm-hmm. PAT mm-hmm. and HIPPY? Okay,
yes.
All right, so you could do both. Mm-hmm. Is that would they be involved from early age mm-hmm. and then at three?
And sometimes after okay. that age, then they might transfer over to HIPPY mm-hmm. and we just do a transition to that.
Okay, from just based on mm-hmm. the needs and what
right.
the...
Yes. Okay. Right, we've actually transitioned some of our children into HIPPY and picked up younger children in the family in Parents as Teachers. You know, but they can also, if the parent wants to do the time commitment, the parent could actually, with the same child, the three-year-old could also be still served with Parents as Teachers if if the parent has the time to do that.
To do that. Well, it sounds like the both programs complement mm-hmm. the family very well and provide different opportunities for the parents and the children. What type of activities you? I know I have seen pictures of a Halloween trick or treat. I've seen pictures of get-togethers, and what are some of the group activities that you all do together? Because relationships, we talked about relationships,
right.
And it's so important in to meet other parents that are. Mm-hmm. That have young children and working together.
Right. Most recently here in South Talladega County, our parent facilitators hosted a Dr. Seuss Day in a group connection on March the 2nd, and that was a really fun event where and well attended, and they had, I believe, different stations where they read books at one and had some little hands-on activities and others, and of course with our group connections, we love to have people who aren't even enrolled in parents as teachers to attend those, you know, so the friends of some of the ones that we serve come sometimes and interact and, like you said, network mm-hmm. with one another and experience and enjoy.
Well, and if anybody is interested in learning more about Pat, Parents as Teachers, I want to use the full name, Parents as Teachers, or the Home Instruction Program for Parents of Preschool Youngsters, HIPPY, what is the number? It's the SAFE's number, which is?
256-245-4343.
Okay, so you heard it, SAFE at 256-245-4343. SAFE is one of the primary partners for Get Healthy Talladega County. And if you're not familiar with SAFE, there are numerous programs all across Talladega County and beyond. And it's just really a go-to place that works together with agencies and programs and people and churches all across Talladega County. But thank you for being with us today.
Thank you.
Thank you for sharing about that and with Katina, with Pre-K as well. And thank you for watching the Get Healthy Talladega County Show.